Rudy Giuliani says Trump should be interviewed by Mueller. Let's take a listen, because this is shocking to me, as it should be to you guys.
For a second special counsel to investigate Spygate, Congressman Matt Gaetz, a member of several key committees, including Budget, Judiciary, and Armed Services. Great to have you with us, Congressman. Let's start with the president's attorney. Now deciding that the president should submit to an interview with a special counsel. Your thoughts?
Any attorney that advises Donald Trump to interview with Bob Mueller needs to immediately put their malpractice insurance carrier on notice, because that would be pretty darn close to legal malpractice.
Totally
agree.
This is
a perjury trap. This was a team that was set up not to investigate crimes, but to get Donald Trump. That's what the start of this investigation was about, from the very first pieces of evidence collected by Peter Strzok. People don't like to point out that the Papadopoulos information came through Peter Strzok, and then somehow lashed into a FISA application to spy on American citizens as a consequence of a dossier that was paid for by the DNC and Hillary Clinton and curated in part by Russians. This is a rotten investigation. We need to call it out for what it is, and to give it dignity by having the president sit in a potential perjury trap would be terrible, terrible advice, and I hope the president does not do that.
This is what I'm saying. This would be terrible advice. So what is Giuliani doing? You see what I'm saying? To give credibility to Mueller? We're trying to discredit Mueller, not give him credibility by having the president of the United States under a false dossier, under false allegations against him that he colluded with Russians or obstructed justice, to sit down with a corrupt special counsel Mueller? Are you kidding me? So why did Giuliani recuse himself when Trump was getting elected, that he was going to be the AG? Then he backed out and Sessions was there. And then Sessions recused himself the next day. And Giuliani now comes in when Trump's attorney Dowd didn't want Trump to sit down with Robert Mueller. This is incredible. Sorry for interrupting, but this is really incredible.
To an interview with a special counsel, your thoughts?
Any attorney that advises Donald Trump to interview with Bob Mueller needs to immediately put their malpractice insurance carrier on notice.
Absolutely.
Because that would be pretty darn close to legal malpractice.
Mm-hmm.
This is a perjury trap. This was a team that was set up not to investigate crimes, but to get Donald Trump. That's what the start of this investigation was about, from
Correct.
The very first pieces of evidence collected by Peter Strzok. People don't like to point out that the Papadopoulos information came through Peter Strzok, and then somehow lashed into a FISA application to spy on American citizens as a consequence of a dossier that was paid for by the DNC and Hillary Clinton and curated in part by Russians. This is a rotten investigation. We need to call it out for what it is, and to give it dignity by having the president sit in a potential perjury trap would be terrible, terrible advice, and I hope the president does not do that.
I think much of the country I sense would agree with you. Yet Giuliani has again taken a stark reversal here in this one. He is surprising a lot of people, and it's just curious the direction he really does intend, if it is not, I hope that the president has plenty of offsetting counsel, I'll put it that way. Let's turn to the FISA meeting you just referred to. We're to see whether or not Trey Gowdy and Devin Nunes, the heads of the Oversight and the Intelligence Committee in the House, get to see those documents. We were basically assured they would. What do you think?
Well, I don't know that they're going to see the documents. I hope they do. There have been other circumstances where the FBI and Department of Justice will just brief on the documents. They won't actually provide them, but will brief on them. So I hope that there's a robust review of the important information. But Lou, if intelligence was collected in any way on Donald Trump's campaign as a consequence of politics or any sort of influence from the Obama White House, that would be deeply troubling. And I am now reminded of the text messages between Peter Strzok and Lisa Page, where they talk about the White House is running this and the White House wants to be kept informed on everything. You know, it really makes you wonder who in the White House were these people communicating with, and were they some of the folks who were then driving the collection of intelligence on the Trump campaign? I think there could be a lot of questions that Obama administration officials have to answer if we get a second special counsel. If we don't get a second special counsel, they'll probably get off, because this Justice Department is not capable of investigating itself.
Rod Rosenstein was with the president in Long Island as the president was conducting that symposium, if you will, on MS-13, the gang violence that has just overwhelmed a good part of Long Island, New York. To see them in the same room and agreeing that there need to be new immigration laws, and at the same time the president apparently acceding to the requests of Schumer and Pelosi for the Gang of Eight to be in a meeting with the Department of Justice and FBI officials after the Memorial Day holiday, is the president being just way too nice to the Dems? Well,
I am not going to give the president advice on HR or who to keep on his team. But look, I am just disgusted that the Democrats have chosen to throw in with MS-13 and criticize the president for his bold action against them. Look, I mean, this should draw us together as a country. MS-13 has just ripped the hearts out of families across America, and we need to attack this problem for what it is, a true threat to our national security. And you'd think this would be a moment of unity with Democrats, but for some reason they've taken common cause with those who just have a position that's any position that's aligned to Donald Trump, it seems.
And the Spygate. The president calls it Spygate, but couldn't it as well be known as Obamagate right now? We've got Lisa Page saying that the White House is driving this, quote unquote, and it appears to have been the case. And then two former spy masters, James Comey and James Clapper, saying this is what we did. We, as a matter of course and procedure, simply spied on political opposition. Who are these people and where did they come from?
Well, I mean, we know that they came out of the Obama administration, and we also know that they're going to get away with it if we don't have a second special counsel. Look, when you've got Rod Rosenstein overseeing, for example, the Mueller probe, which is a reviewing obstruction of justice, and Rod Rosenstein, you know, wrote the memo to fire James Comey, and they view that as the basis of their obstruction of justice claim, it just shows the level of conflict of interest that these folks are willing to tolerate, whether it's the unfair persecution of President Trump or the yellow brick road that was paved for Hillary Clinton, despite her use of bleach bit on documents that had been requested by the Congress. I mean, these are outrageous biases in both directions, and I think we need someone who's not from the swamp, someone who is not of the Justice Department, to come in and serve as a special counsel to determine where they broke their procedures and potentially broke the law, especially if intelligence was collected on the Trump campaign.
And it becomes, of course, critically important who is appointed to be that special counsel and by whom. We have watched that turn into a disaster, and as the president calls it, and I think calls it exactly accurately, a witch hunt that has persisted for more than a year. We don't want a repetition of that, do we?
No, look, we certainly don't. And I don't like special counsels, but here we're in a situation where the membership of the Judiciary Committee has called for a special counsel, where the Judiciary Chairman Bob Goodlatte has called for a special counsel, where Trey Gowdy has called for one, the Majority Leader Kevin McCarthy, the Majority Whip Steve Scalise. So we're having a broad base of the support from the Republican Party that want to get real answers. And the question is whether or not we'll continue to allow the Justice Department to drive the train on these investigations, or whether there is a higher level of scrutiny and review that they ought to be subjected to.
And the president, to his great credit, has called for absolute transparency in moving ahead, and it begins with this meeting tomorrow with Chairman Nunes and Chairman Gowdy. This is a president right now who is beset from every angle. Do you think we're moving toward a conclusion?
I don't know. That troubles me. The fact that we continue to go forward with the Mueller investigation when we know it's built on a rotten foundation, when we know that the original intelligence was collected by people who hated the president and were working on an insurance policy to discredit the president, there would not be any possible prosecution that would be successful from this. And so I think the goal is just to drag it on and to continue to have a cloud over the Trump presidency to potentially sway voters voters in the midterm elections. I don't think that there is a sincere investigatory outcome here. I think it's largely turned into a political exercise. And the reason I believe that, Lou, is that we continue to see examples where people at the FBI and Department of Justice were not acting as investigators and attorneys. They were acting as political hacks, leaking information to the press. And then even when they knew stuff wasn't credible, presenting it to a FISA court. This is to achieve a political outcome, not to deliver justice. And that's what troubles me as a member of the Judiciary Committee.
And as Joe DiGenova, former special prosecutor himself, said, this is an outright effort to frame the President of the United States. And it is clearly that, as anyone who follows these developments day to day.
And I totally agree with that. You see, and DiGenova couldn't come in. You see, they're trying to frame Trump. And for Rudy Giuliani to say that Trump should be interviewed by Mueller, it's beyond outrageous. And even Matt Gaetz says, I don't know where this is going to end. You know, because it's like the whole cabal is after Trump. You know what I'm saying? Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. And again, thank you so much for watching.